cross product with AR cap will give you A pi cap. Please note down. This has to be satisfied. Okay. So cross product of the unit vectors. Okay. All these vectors are perpendicular to each other. Once if you make cross product in a sequential manner, taking cross product of pi with R, what I will get? In the reverse way.
Minus A.
I will get minus A z cap. I will get minus A z cap. Similarly, that is for all other combinations. Okay. For all other combinations. Okay. So this is the idea of the cylindrical coordinate system. Cylindrical coordinate system. This is how to call point. Okay. Now, what is the final idea? That this is the R, sir. Radial distance, radial perpendicular distance from the z axis. That is R. Again, what is pi? What is pi? Pi means from this plane. Okay, for this point, I cannot calculate angle from this like this. It's wrong. Okay, once if you assume yourself that is from x axis, that is wrong. That is from what? Clearly, that is from x z plane. The angle has to be calculated from x z plane. Okay, once if you are here, once if you are here, your angle has to be calculated from this place only. Here you will have some plane. Again, from that plane only you have to calculate your angle. Okay, that is the idea of the angle and the radius value, radius of the cylinder. Okay. Next, what I will do, I will go to the document. Okay, anyway, that one more coordinate system is there, like spherical coordinate system, and that will be a little bit tough because one more domain is there will be two angles. Okay, one radius and two angle will be there, and imagination will be a little bit difficult there. Okay, so anyway, given for a particular coordinate system, say if it is a rectangular coordinate system xyz, at any point of time if you take some point, what will be your unit vector? Because this is very easy, because you are very familiar with this coordinate system, so this is the unit vectors. Okay, and again range they given, minus infinity to plus infinity. Okay, so then they given one more thing. What is xy plane? Morning explained. Xy plane is what? Y is equal to 0. Y is the plane is x equal to 0. And again, if you take some other constant value for y, that plane will be parallel to the y is equal to 0 plane. So these are all parallel planes. You can make parallel planes like this. To be changed, then only you will get volume. If you are making changes in any two variable, then you will get a surface. If you make change in any two of the variable, you will get surface. Yes, anyone?
Six
surfaces are possible. Yes, six surfaces are possible. Okay, and then how to take a surface vector for this? Now I am having some closed surface. What will be the surface vector for this one? Anybody? See, for this line, what will be the surface vector? Y cap or minus y cap? Yeah, clearly given, clearly told in the morning, once it is close to surface, the surface vector has to go outside. So surface vector for this is y cap. Surface vector for this side is minus y cap. Surface vector for this is z cap. Surface vector for this is minus z cap. Surface vector for this is x cap. Again, inside surface vector is minus x cap. Are you understanding? What do you mean by surface vector? Now, yes, this is the surface vector for a given surface. Okay. So that means what I am telling, at any point of time, you will get dx and dy. Okay. Dx and dy, there is a change in x and change in y. definitely your surface vector will be either x z cap or minus z cap, depending upon whether you are taking upside or downside. Okay, once if you are having changes in dx and dy, definitely your surface vector will be z cap, but whether it is plus z cap or minus z cap, that depends on what, whether you are having upper surface or lower surface. Okay, surface vector always has to go outside the surface, outside the surface. So this is the way. That means what I am telling, at any point of time you can make, with this you can make three combinations only, but you have to differentiate with the minus and the plus cap. Okay, minus, then finally you will get six combination. Okay, next, so what is the differential length? What is the differential length changes? Differential length in the sense, if you are making x, y, z, what is the final change in length? Length means here the length is from arc length, generally arc length. What is the change? If I am moving one point from this way, then what is the difference? Okay, from the center point, like this is from the center point, what is the change in the length? So that is very simple, square root of x square plus y square plus z square. Next, they clearly given what is a z cap. A z cap is always what, perpendicular to the surface dy dz. Okay, this is the surface vector for the dy dz surface. A x cap is the surface vector for the dy and dz, and it is always perpendicular to that surface. Again, they clearly given what is surface vector. A surface vector is a vector which is always perpendicular to that surface. That is the definition. Okay, like this you can get for other combinations. And again, here the cylindrical coordinate system, rho comma pi comma z. Please remember, rho and pi are exactly same. Please don't confuse with that. In order to differentiate this from the spherical coordinate system, they are using here rho. That's it. Because there r is having different idea. Here r is having different idea. Here r means what, sir? Always measured from the perpendicular distance, measured from the z axis. So in order to differentiate, sometime they are using different notation. But you have to be very clear what is rho, what is r. Okay, it is just a notation. Okay, rho is equal to constant. So r is equal to constant mean what it is giving? Circular cylinder. R is equal to constant, what it is giving? Circular cylinder. Okay, in the morning I have explained. Okay, if you take some coordinate system, when you are fixing rho or r, you will get a cylindrical coordinate system. Somebody tell me, if this value of rho or r is 2, I am taking r is equal to 3, I will be forming an another surface like this. What is the relation between these two surfaces? I am having one surface with r is equal to 2 and another surface with r is equal to 3. What is the relation between these two surfaces? Will they intersect each other? They will not intersect each other. Okay, that means these two surfaces are what? Parallel to each other. These two surfaces are parallel to each other. Are you getting that idea? Yes. R is equal to 2 is giving one surface, R is equal to 3 giving another surface. These two surfaces are parallel to each other, parallel to each other. In ordinary coordinate system, what you have done? You taken y is equal to 1 will give you the line, and y is equal to 2 will give you another line. These two lines are what? Parallel to each other. These two lines are parallel to each other. Okay, similarly here also you are getting two surfaces. Okay, they are parallel to each other. Next, pi is equal to constant. They clearly given is a half plane, a semi infinite plane. Rotate with z axis. Z axis is a base axis for this one. Say if this is 0 degree, it keeps on rotating in this direction. It keeps on rotating as you change the angle. This plane is keep on rotating. Okay, from the x z plane. Okay, the base plane is this plane. This is x z plane. This is the base. From 0 degree will be here. From x z plane it keeps on rotating. Okay, next, z equal to constant, they given it is a horizontal plane, because once if z is constant you will get some plane there, so that is horizontal plane. Okay, then they given what is a pi, the direction of increasing rho, that is called a pi. Say for example, if I am having like this, okay, if I am having like this, if I want to calculate what is a rho here, definitely this is a rho. Okay, because rho has to be measured from the central axis, say z axis. So this is the increasing direction of rho. If I want to calculate here, this is a rho. Okay, so that is the concept of arrow. If I am putting here, or otherwise I can put here also. If this is the point, this is the arrow. Okay, this is the arrow. So the direction of increasing row, that is called arrow. Then what is A phi? Direction of increasing pi. Say if I am having like this, if my circle is in the base, it is in the base axis. Okay, say it is in the base axis. X, Y, is that? What is the increasing direction of pi? This is the increasing direction of pi. Now my pi is like this. Here increases. So this will be my A pi direction. Okay, this will be at any point of time you draw the tangential line towards the increasing direction. That is A pi. So what is the A pi here? This will be the A pi. Okay, tangential line. Just a tangential line. What will be the A pi here? This will be the A pi. Okay, this is like a for a base. Base you are written like this. If it is not in the base, it can be anywhere else. Say, again your circle may be here. Sometime, that time what is A pi? There you have to draw in the increasing direction. Okay, that is the concept of A pi. Okay, pi means measurement of what? Pi is the angle measurement from the x z plane, not from the x. It is from the x z plane. Okay, that is the idea. Now z is very simple. Increasing direction of z. If it is a z point, then you can increase. If it is a point, then this will be the z cap of that point. This will be the z cap. Direction of increasing z. Okay. Now you see here, they given a cylinder portion. Again, please remember, this will be extended up to infinite in this direction, because z value is from minus infinity to plus infinity. They clearly given the limit minus infinity to plus infinity for pi 0 to 2 pi. For radial distance it is 0 to pi. For radial distance it is 0 to pi. Okay, now this is extending up to infinite. Again, this is extending up to minus infinite. Okay, somehow say this is somewhat they given here. Now how much portion of the cylinder we are seeing, sir? Here, how much portion of the cylinder now it is visible to us? Anybody? Anyway, the cylinder has to extend from minus infinity to plus infinity. Yes.
Pi.
How much portion of the cylinder is visible to us? And again, please remember that this anyway they have just extended here, so this is okay up to infinite. You assume that. Anybody?
Sir, 1/3, sir, 120 degrees.
No, not 1/3. You please imagine. Once you are some portion of the cylinder is visible to you, how much portion?
X-Z plane.
Okay, and again, please remember one thing: only half of the cylinder is available with you. Bottom half is not there because it cannot be drawn here. Okay. Only see if this is a cylinder. Only top portion is they are showing here. Bottom portion they are not showing. Even in the top portion, you are having only in one quarter. Even in the top portion, you are having only in one quarter. Okay, 1/4 only visible. Okay, because there are four quadrants. There will be four quadrants. Only one quadrant is visible. So actually, what you are seeing 1/8 of the cylinder. Is it correct? Yes, others think of this. There is a cylinder. Here it is visible to you. Only 1/8 of the cylinder. Is it correct? That is the main problem. Why we are not understanding? Why we are having difficulty to understand this? Yes, are you all agree with this? If okay, we will proceed. You are getting only 1/8 of the cylinder. How 1/8? Suppose there is a cylinder. Only top portion is here. Bottom portion they are not showing here, because in 2D paper it cannot be shown. Even in the top portion, only they are showing in one quadrant. There will be four quadrant. Okay, there will be four quadrant generally. Only one quadrant they are showing. So 1/4 is visible. Only 1/4. Again, totally another bottom portion is there. There four pieces will be there. So only 1/8 of the portion is visible to you. Is it correct, sir? Anybody?
Sir.
Are you able to imagine this? Please imagine. This is the upper portion. Similar portion will be in the bottom also. Similar portion will be the bottom also. And again, this can be extended actually. This is minus z. So similar portion will be there also. That side also. See, you are getting the something in xy plane. Similarly, it will be available in y minus x plane also, because there will be a plane called minus x and y. Okay, once if you extend this, there will be one more plane, minus x and y. There also you should have, okay, minus x y plane. Again, if you extend this, here you will have x minus y plane, x minus y plane, and again you will have minus y minus x plane, minus y minus x plane. Okay, those are all missing. Okay, again you are seeing only upper portion. Again, only you are seeing upper portion. Like this, similar thing will be there in the bottom portion. Okay, below the xy plane, below the xy plane, again same thing. Everything will be available. That is the cylinder. Okay. Now they have taken one random point. They have taken this point. See how they are mentioning that arrow. Arrow means what, sir? Rho means r, radial distance, not from this. Radial distance, not from this. This is wrong. R means what? Radial or perpendicular distance from the z axis, from the z axis. It is not from the center point. It is not from the center point. It is from the z axis. Okay, so that's why this is arrow they are mentioning for that particular point. They are mentioning arrow. Okay, this is arrow. Okay, next, pi. What is the increasing direction of the pi? Pi is changing in this way. Pi is changing in this way. So that means what? This is the increasing direction of the pi. So here my a pi will be like this. Here it will be like this. Here it will be like this. Like this, it keeps on changing. Okay, my a pi. So they put the a pi here, the tangential component, the two in the increasing direction. A pi, a z is very simple. Anyway, towards x. Okay. Again, you see whether it follows the right hand coordinate system or not. Yes, it is, because rho comes first, pi comes second. Then in the thumb direction there will be z. In the thumb direction there will be z. Okay. Now, in reality, how to position your point? If you are having some point here, how will you measure? What is the? How will you calculate this rho and pi and z? You are having some point in the cylindrical coordinate system. Generally, how will you measure that point values? Okay. See, what is the idea? Once if you have this point value, you can point out the point. Or if you are given a point, from the point value, you should be able to calculate this. Values rho and pi comma z. Okay, what is the idea, sir? In ordinary system, what you will do? Suppose they given 1, 2, 3. With this, you can position some point. Okay, or otherwise, in some question, if they given a point, then you should be able to point out 1, 2, 3. That is the idea. Now I am going to work out in the reverse. Okay, you are given a point. How to calculate that point coordinates? What is the coordinates of the point? Okay. Now say they given you some point like this. Okay, in the space. How to calculate that rho first? First of all, from this point you have to go perpendicular or radial distance to reach z. That will give you the what, sir? Rho. Okay. Or otherwise, the simple idea is, once if you have a point in the space, you project that point in the xy plane. You project top view. What will be the top view? You are having one point in the space. If you are making top view, definitely it will fall on what, sir? XY plane. Okay, or space la or point irukku, adu neenga mele irundha top view la pathina adanude projection enga irukum? XY plane la irukum. Adanude projection enga irukum? XY plane la irukum. Again, once XY plane ku vandha, very simple, neenga enna pannidalam? Inga irundha indha radial distance calculate pannalam. So appo dhaan ungalku enna kedaikum? Rho kedaikum. Rho ku vandu kedaikum. Again, neenga space la irundhalume anga irundha z kuda distance calculate pannalam. Adhu onnava dhaan sir irukum. Rho va dhaan sir irukum. Ena cylinder ku radial vandu enna poradhu kedaiyadhu, mara poradhu kedaiyadhu. Cylinder oda radius நீங்க எங்க இருந்து மெஷர் பண்ணாலும் என்ன பண்ண போறது கிடையாது, மாற போறது கிடையாது. அதாவது சிலிண்டர் இது போல இருக்குன்னா இங்க இருந்து ரேடியல் கண்டுபிடினா எப்படி மெஷர் பண்ணுவா? எங்க இருந்து கண்டுபிடினா என்ன பண்ணுவா? இப்படி மெஷர் பண்ணுவா. எங்க இருந்து கண்டுபிடிச்சாலும் என்ன மாறாது? ரோ வந்து மாறாது. ஸோ ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஐடியா வந்து என்னது? ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ப்ரொஜெக்ட் பண்ணிடுங்க. ப்ரொஜெக்ட் பண்ணிட்டு ரோவை கண்டுபிடிக்கலாம். அகைன் நெக்ஸ்ட் க்வெஸ்சன் இஸ் ஹவு டு கால்குலேட் பை. ஆஃப்டர் ப்ரொஜெக்ஷன் யூ கால்குலேட் த ஆங்கிள் ஃப்ரம் த இசட் ஆக்சிஸ். தட் இஸ் வெரி சிம்பிள், பிகாஸ் யூ ஆர் ப்ரொஜெக்டட் யுவர் பாயிண்ட் டு தி எக்ஸ்ஒய் பிளேன். நவ் கால்குலேட் த ஆங்கிள் ஃப்ரம் தி x-axis, then you will get pi. Or otherwise, if you want to calculate the angle from this, you have to calculate the angle from this x-z plane. This is the angle. See, here this is the x-z plane. Okay, this is the x-z plane. Sir, please note down, this is the x-z plane. Okay, you have to calculate the angle from the x-z plane. Okay, in the space la irukinglo anga irukra xy plane la direct ah enna kandupidikanum, perpendicular angle vandu enna nu kandupidikanum. So you will get pi. Then how you will get z, sir? Z is very easy. Again, you before projection you have to measure the perpendicular distance. What is the perpendicular distance? What is height of your point? What is the height of your point from the base, from XY, because XY is base, from the base, what is your height? That will give you the Z, that will give you the Z. This is the idea. அதாவது என்ன சொல்ல வர, கோஆர்டினேட்ஸ் தந்துட்டாங்கன்னா உங்களுக்கு பாயிண்ட் நோட் பண்ண தெரியணும், பாயிண்ட் தந்துட்டாங்கன்னா அதுல இருந்து என்னது கோஆர்டினேட்ஸ் நோட் பண்ண தெரியணும். இதுதான் வந்து சிம்பிள் ஐடியா. நெக்ஸ்ட், வாட் இஸ் த டிஃபரன்ஷியல் வால்யூம்? வாட் இஸ் த டிஃபரன்ஷியல் வால்யூம்? வால்யூம் மீன்ஸ் வாட் சார்? சேஞ்ச் இன் த பராமீட்டர். வி ஆர் ஹேவிங் த்ரீ பராமீட்டர், ரோ கமா பை கமா இசட். ஒன்ஸ் இஃப் யூ சேஞ்ச் ரோ, then d rho. Once if you change pi, this is not simple d pi, you will get a rho d phi. Why? Can anybody explain? If you make angle, yes, anyone? Once if you make change in rho, that is simply d rho. Once if you make change in z, that is d z. But once if you change in theta, that is not d theta.
Because the angle is measured from xz plane, sir.
No madam, angle is measured from, okay, that is okay, that exactly. What I'm telling, it is radial not distance. It is not simply rho phi, sorry, it is not simply d phi. What is the reason? Change in
radial
angle,
radial distance from center point.
Yeah, actually see here, see I'm having some point, yeah radial, arc length has to be measured. Yes I will explain, wait, okay. Say wait a bit, please. See, I am here. Say, I just moved this in this way. Okay, my rho is not changed. I am moving in this way. So first I was here. Now I went to a new place here. What is not changed, sir? Definitely, the z is not changed. Z is not changed. Then what is not changed? Rho is not changed. But what is changed? My pi is changed. Okay, little bit pi extra I went. Okay, say for example, how much extra phi I went? Let me take d phi. Initially I was in pi, now I added with the d pi. Now my change is only d pi. Okay, now my angle change is d phi. Okay, once I am changing the angle, what arc length I am getting? That is the important thing, sir. What is the arc length? Okay, that arc length is rho d phi. Are you understanding? Yes. Arc length. What is the change in the arc length? You are changing the angle, but ultimately what is happening? That arc length is getting changed. The arc length is getting changed. That's why here you will get d rho. Here you will not get simple d phi. You will get rho d phi, and you will get d z, and you will get d z. Okay. And somebody, what is that change in the angle value? What is the angle value actually? Is it a number or degree? You are giving a rho d phi here. What is the unit of angle? See, somebody please tell me, what is the unit of volume? Anyone? What is the unit of volume?
Unit of meter cube. Angle radian.
Okay, please wait a bit. Unit of volume is meter cube. You are making change in d rho, so definitely you are making change in meter. Again, you are making change in z, that will also give you some meter. Anyway, meter and meter will not give you meter cube. Definitely one more meter has to come. But if you are changing just angle, it will not give you what? Meter. Definitely some parameter, distance parameter has to come. That's why rho d phi. Again, here rho d phi, here they are giving. But see, one thing that rho d phi is an approximation, I think. That is not your ideal value. That rho d phi is approximation. Actually, you will get rho sine d phi, I think. Is it not? Generally, to calculate any distance, you have to use either sine formula or cos formula with the radial distance. So it is rho sine d phi. As d phi is very, very small, sine d phi can be represented as d phi. What is the unit of sine phi? Anybody? Sine phi is a simple number. Is it not? Sin pi is a simple number. Anyway, that is approximated to d pi. Again, that is also a number. So here, in this case, d pi is a number. In general, d pi is a degree or radian. But in this case, this is approximation to sin pi, I think. So that's why you are getting, again, meter only you will get. So finally, meter cube. Finally, meter cube. Please, somebody verify this. So we are getting rho d pi. But the actual value is rho sin d phi. Is it correct or not? Somebody verify, okay, whether it is correct or not. Otherwise, if it is not correct, we will get unit contradiction here. What unit contradiction? In this way, you will get meter cube here, meter cube, and degree or radian. Some kind of unit contradiction will be there. If it is true, again, sin d phi is actually a number, then there is no problem. Okay, there is no unit contradiction. Please, somebody verify this, whether dou phi is derived actually from rho sin d phi. Yes?
Yes, sir. It is verified, sir. D phi is small value.
Okay. Sin so d actually, is... so sin d phi is the correct value, but it has been derived from that. Yes. Okay. Hmm. Okay. Because it has to be like that only. Otherwise, that unit will not be satisfied. Okay. Next. Again, what are the differential surfaces I can get? Different surfaces. Okay. See. Please remember, please note down, you are having cylinder. Okay. Now, what are the different surfaces I can get? Actually, there are three surfaces. This is one surface, second surface, and this is a lateral surface. Please imagine yourself, if you are in a lateral surface, you are choosing some area on the lateral surface, which parameter will be constant? There are three parameters. Rho, pi, z. There are three parameters. Rho, pi, z. When you are in the surface, lateral surface, which parameter will be constant? Anybody?
Pi, sir.
Not pi. Pi will vary, no? If you are going in this direction, pi will vary. If you are going in this direction, z will vary. Rho is constant. When you are on the surface, what is constant? Rho is constant. Okay, when you are going inside, your rho will decrease. You are on the surface only. Okay, whenever you are on the surface, rho is constant. Please note down, when you are in the lateral surface, what is constant? Rho is constant. Please imagine, sir, suppose or sphere irukke, sphere oda surface la neenga enga ponalum radial distance change avuma? Change avadu. Adhe pola da cylinder la neenga surface la irukkumbodhu enga ponalum ungalaudaya radial distance naavadu. Radial distance neenga definition enna? Anga irundhu irukra perpendicular distance to the z axis, to the central axis. So na change avadu radial radius of the cylinder vandha avadu change avadu. So what is constant in the lateral surface? What is constant? Rho is constant. Pi and z can be anything. So what is the idea? If I am choosing some surface on the lateral surface, if I am choosing some small surface on the lateral surface, what will be the variable? Pi will be variable and z will be variable. That's why if it is a lateral surface, if it is a lateral surface, what is variable? Pi is variable and d is a variable. What is the unit vector for this lateral surface? Anybody? Whenever you are on a lateral surface, what is the unit vector for that surface? What will be the perpendicular vector for that lateral surface? The unit vector for this surface is k rho cap. The unit vector for this surface is a rho cap, some kind of vector coming outwards from the central axis, radially outward from the center axis. Okay, so again the unit vector for the lateral surface is d phi dz. Again, it is very simple. Inga enna pi variable irukku, z variable irukku, appo illadhu ennadhu? A rho. Adhu dhaan kandippa annava irukkanum, and the surface ku unit vector ah irukkanum, and the surface ku unit vector ah irukkanum. Okay, idhu vandu lateral surface ku idea sir. Idhu vandu ennadhu? Lateral surface. Again, please remember, what is the change in pi? Change in pi nal enna pannom? Rho d phi podanum. Change in pi nal enna varum nammalku? Rho d phi dz. Rho d phi dz. Okay, then this is the lateral surface area. Lateral surface area is rho d phi dz. Now, what is the another plane, sir? Can I take a plane like this? Sorry. See, can it, please wait a bit. Suppose this is the cylinder. Okay, can I take a plane in the upper surface? This is also a surface. Okay, in the upper surface also, what I can take some small surface. Okay, if I am taking a surface in the upper surface which is constant, which is variable. It means what, sir? I can take anywhere. I can take anywhere on this upper surface. That is the idea. Wherever you are taking, okay, your z will be what, sir? Constant. Wherever you are taking on the upper surface, you can take anywhere on this upper surface. What will be constant? Z will be constant. What will be constant? Z will be constant. What is the variable? Okay, depending on the place you are taking, your rho is variable and d phi is variable. So then what is the variable? Rho into rho d phi. Then what is the surface? What is the surface? Rho square d phi. Rho square, sorry, not again, the change is here, d rho. Please wait a bit. The change in rho is d rho, the change in phi is rho d phi. Then what is the final answer? Rho d rho d phi. Okay, this is the upper surface. Then what is the unit vector, sir, for this one? If I am taking upper surface, what is the unit vector? Somebody please tell me. What is the unit vector for the upper surface? Yes, z cap. The unit vector. Yeah, z cap.